professionals, this is Utkarsh Rai, and today I am taking up another topic around COVID-19. Restarting work after COVID-19 set three expectations for 1 year. According to the World Economic Forum, the world is facing a double disruption scenario, automation and COVID-19. We were already worried about our jobs becoming redundant due to automation, and then came COVID-19, which disrupted our lives more and beyond. Workplaces have 15 to 35% professionals impacted due to COVID-19. Some of them have experienced personal griefs too. Rest of the professionals, on seeing the state of their co-workers and friends, are equally worried because COVID-19 is not over yet. The first wave of COVID-19 forced us to work from home, and it took us time to get adjusted to a new routine. Video calls and long work hours intertwined with personal chores became the new normal. Virtual chit-chats replaced water cooler talks. Second wave has changed that too. People are avoiding to turn on their video camera. They just wanted to focus on the work-related talk rather than chit-chatting. COVID-related weakness triggered weight loss and pale face. Under-eye circuits have grown due to grief. Fitness freak lost muscles. They just don't want to come on video to become a topic of discussion. They are hiding under their own shells. They restarted to work while recuperating due to many anxieties. My project will be assigned to someone else. My performance appraisal will get impacted. My promotion will get delayed. I will not get any new exciting project. If company suffers loss, I will lose my job, and so on. As per the recently released McKinsey report, anxiety is decreasing work performance, reducing job satisfaction, and negatively impacting interpersonal relationship with co-workers, among other ills. Lessons from the past will help us overcome anxieties, and luckily, we have a documented history of Spanish flu. So let's look into two aspects of Spanish flu. First, Spanish flu lasted for more than 2 years, from 1918 to 1920. COVID will set to appear weaker from 2022, as was the case with the Spanish flu. Second, Thomas Garrett study on 1918 pandemic effect on economy says, positively and statistically significant correlation exists between the statewide influenza-induced mortality rate and state per capita income growth. After 1920, economy bounced with better job market and higher wages. You need to be optimistic about your future. So professionals, watch my video till end to know how you will sail through the next 1 year by setting three expectations right. And if you have not already liked and subscribed to my channel, then please do it. And also watch my playlist of videos on topic around COVID-19 to solve your unanswered questions. Seijal Samuel wrote on Fox.com, people are also realizing the intense career pressure they had felt pre-pandemic obscured many of their life priorities. So what is your priority for the next 1 year? Certainly, you have to look after your mental and physical health, because then only you will be able to achieve your three expectations. So block your calendar for mental and physical fitness and inform your stakeholder and give the reason behind blocking it. Scientists searching for the equation for happiness says, lower expectation but not to a level where you will feel miserable is the key for a happy life. So let us look into three expectations which you can lower it but still you will not feel miserable. First, productivity. One professional with whom I interacted said he could focus only 30 minutes to an hour at a time because he get distracted with the thoughts of his parents whom he lost recently due to COVID. Some of them are facing fatigue, some of them are having headache, and some of them are unable to engage in in-depth conversation. They all are experiencing loss of productivity. It is okay if your productivity is less, but you should be transparent and share your situation with your stakeholders. And you should keep updating them as you improve. Management has four options under these circumstances. First, they will reprioritize the project. Second, they will negotiate an extended deadline with the customer. Third, they will provide help to you. Or fourth, they will assign your work to someone else. You should enthusiastically support your management in choosing one of these options. Self-recuperation with less work worries should be your priority. Second expectation, performance appraisal. Irrespective of what was your performance level last year, set in your mind that this year you are going to get an average appraisal. In a multi-decade career, 1 year doesn't have a long-term impact. Even before COVID, people did have bad patches. By setting this expectation lower, you will be happier and there is always an upside. Third, career development. Project changes, more responsibilities, bigger roles, visible promotion are some of them which you might be aspiring in this year. If it happens, it is well and good. But if it is not, it is okay because this is not a rare opportunity and you are going to get such opportunities in future too. This approach, you are setting the upcoming year as a preparation year. You lower your expectation and focus on self-development and self-care. This will enable you to ride the upcoming economic boom wave. I hope you like this video. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.